Let's talk about an interesting cause of air hunger, okay? And I'm talking about the symptom of shortness of breath, the medical term being dyspnea, where you just can't breathe well. Now, the typical reasons why you might have difficulty breathing would be, let's say you have asthma or a chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, a problem with the lung because you had a history of smoking, or pneumonia, or TB. And by the way, 25% of the population on planet Earth have latent TB. It's a bacterial infection that goes in remission, doesn't create any symptoms in the majority of population, but in certain people, it will come out of remission when the resistance is low, or let's say the other health problems, or they get older. But the majority of people don't have any symptoms from this, but it does affect the lungs. And did you realize in the year 2018, 1.5 million people died of TB? All right, moving right along. Anxiety. People that have panic attacks or they have anxiety always have a weird breathing pattern. Their exhalation is very, very short compared to their inhalation. So they're doing this. So a real simple thing you could do if you have anxiety or a panic attack or you're trying to sleep and you're worried is start to slow down your breathing, where you're breathing very slowly for about 5 seconds, 4 or 5 seconds in, and then 4 or 5 seconds out slowly. And you'll find your entire mood will change. So you're basically affecting the autonomic nervous system, pulling yourself out of that flight or fight mode. All right, number 6, an allergy. 7, anemia. And even a congested gallbladder issue, because it's going to swell up or it's going to back up through the bile ducts and put pressure on your diaphragm. And you need your diaphragm to breathe. And so these are the, I'd say, common reasons why people have air hunger. But there's another reason which is not really well known, and it has to do with your pH. So you have two conditions. You have acidosis and alkalosis. In acidosis, you get these symptoms: headache, fatigue, tremors, sleepiness, coughing, and here we have shortness of breath. So acidosis will definitely cause air hunger. In alkalosis, we have muscle weakness, muscle pain, muscle cramping, hypocalcemia, low calcium in the blood, tetany, which is a little twitching you'd get maybe somewhere in your body, and sometimes it could definitely affect the breathing as well. But I didn't put it down there because it's not very common. But if you have air hunger and you want to figure out if you're too acid or too alkaline, all you have to do is take some calcium or magnesium or potassium and see if you can start breathing better, okay? And that could indicate that you're maybe too acid. Now, or you can start taking apple cider vinegar or betaine hydrochloride, which is an acidifier. And if you can start breathing better, then we know this could be the cause of that problem. Now, the three things that might cause alkalosis would be you don't have enough stomach acid, so you have a lot of digestive problems and bloating, or high levels of cortisol, chronic stress, or low potassium will cause alkalosis. As far as acidosis goes, this usually happens when you have severe liver problems. A version of it can occur if you're doing a longer fast because you're into some serious ketosis and ketones are more acidic. Or it could be that you're drinking too much apple cider vinegar, or in my case, I started drinking too much kombucha tea and I started to develop acidosis. So I just simply took some calcium, boom, it went away. And then I just made sure when I drank kombucha tea that I only had a little bit. So anyway, I just want to increase your awareness and expand all the potential causes of air hunger. Thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call, but I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.